Hello friends, how are you all? I am Advocate Shivshankar Mishra and welcome to our channel Legal Darpan. Friends, today we are going to discuss about Wakalatnama in a question answer form. So please watch the video till the last, and if you failed after watching the video, good better, then please subscribe my YouTube channel. So let's start the video. So first question is, what is Wakalatnama? Answer: Wakalatnama is a written document that is given by a client to an advocate to appear and or plead before any court of law on behalf of him. There is no mention of any particular definition of Wakalatnama in the Civil Procedure Code 1908 as well as the Power of Attorney Act 1882. Second question is, who can authorize a Wakalatnama? An aggrieved person can authorize a Wakalatnama. Third question is, what are the contents of a Wakalatnama? Wakalatnama, under the Wakalatnama, there are lot of contents mentioned. The first point, the date Wakalatnama would be executed. Next point, the name of the case which the advocate is being appointed. Next point, the name of the court which the advocate is being appointed. Next point, the name of the person authorized the advocates. Next point, the advocate address so appointed. Next point, the power is given to the lawyer. Next point, signature of the parties. Next point, advocate signature accepting the Wakalatnama. Question number 4, what are terms under a Wakalatnama? The first point, answer: regardless of a lawyer decision, a client shall not hold him or her responsible. Next point, all the cost involved in the case shall be borne by the client. Next point, the lawyer has a right to keep the documents until the agreed fees are paid. Next point, the lawyer has the right to take any decision he or she deems fit during the hearing of the case. Next point, the court fees payment should be attached. Question number 5, how long does the validity of a Wakalatnama last? Answer: a Wakalatnama is valid until A. point, the death of the client, or B, the death of the lawyer, or C, the client withdraw it, or D. number point, a court gives approval for the lawyer to withdraw it. E. number point, the conclusion of the court case. 6. number question, how to cancel a Wakalatnama? Answer: there are situations whereby you no longer have confidence in your advocates and you wish to cancel the Wakalatnama is ordered to appoint a new advocate without canceling the existing Wakalatnama, because your previous advocate can take decision which you will be liable for. And last question, this is the very important question, that how to fill or write a Wakalatnama. Let us take a look fresh Wakalatnama. You will learn how we can properly fill this form. Just take a look. After fill this form, and we will start that how did I fill this Wakalatnama. As you can see at the top of the box, this box is used for pasting of court fee and advocate welfare fund tickets. Also, a court fee is decided by a court fee act, and according to the local law it changes. When we talk about the Delhi, most of this district judge required 2 rupees court fees. And after that, in the court of, right here, judge name or his or her post and place of the court. That means honorable judge name XYZ MM, that means Metropolitan Magistrate, and whatever he or she hold the post and place the court. Suit ovaling appeal number. If you are filing the case first time, you may not be able to know what the suit or case number. So you have to leave this blank. And if you are filing the case or appointed as an advocate of opposite party, then you will know that what is the suit number. Then mention here suit number. And jurisdiction of, and mention here year of the suit. In RE, write here party name. That means ABC versus XYZ. Couple of name mention here. That means plaintiff, appellant, petition, complainant versus defendant, respondent, accused. Whatever you will be choose, that is totally depend on nature of suit. If you are going to file a civil suit, then tick on plaintiff. If you are petitioner, then tick on petitioner. If you are appellant, then tick on appellant. If you are filing to a criminal case, then tick on complainants. If you are opposite party in civil case, then tick on defendant or respondent. If you are going to file a criminal case, then tick on accused. Sorry, if you are accused, then tick on accused. So know all the to whom this person shall, that I we mention here client name, client's father's name and client's address. The above named, mention here character of the party. Example, if you are going to file a civil case, then mention here plaintiff. If you are opposite party in civil case, then mention here defendant. If you are going to file a criminal case, then mention here complainant. If you are accused, then mention here accused. If you are going to appeal upper court, then write here appellant or petitioner, whatever you are. And here is also a one box. This box can be also used for court fees or for donation purpose. The last line is fill in the blanks here. Right here, date of the suit and year of the suit and month of the suit. So bottom of the line or last of the line, advocate. Above the advocate line, sign here advocate, left hand side, and in front of client, above the client, upper the client line, sign here client. So this was the full knowledge of Wakalatnama.